and openness, but how do we make business? How do we create companies? How do we innovate in Europe in that field? Because we can, and I'll come back to that. So if you just look at the broad picture, because what happens with research and innovation in general is similar to what happens, I think, in information and communication technologies. This is the innovation effort, R&D intensity. You may remember the Lisbon Agenda. And we all know that Europe is still under the 2%, a 2% threshold, and US and Japan much above. This is total R&D expenditures. It's an indication of innovation efforts. Total means public and business. If you look at business R&D expenditures, you see that, Europe business R&D is at 1%, and it's actually nowadays below what China is doing. So you will tell me China is more D, Europe is more R, but it means that there is a more dynamic entrepreneurial process in China than in Europe. And the US is much above the level of Europe. So we don't invest enough. We have a less entrepreneurial culture. And what we heard this morning is very good for, if you look at the title of the conference, creating an open and competitive market for IT users. I applaud that. But we need IT entrepreneurs as well. And this is more about. So you have two types of innovations that we can talk about. It's either new technology-intensive domains. You know, well, you have artificial intelligence, nanotechnologies, biotech, Web 2.0, and so on. It's an important role of academic research, of course, but not only academic research. And then non-technology innovation, and this is what we talk about as well today. Non-technology innovation in marketing, if you look at what the business process of Google, it's based on a very innovative marketing business. It's new design approach, business models, and of course open innovation, open sources, and so on. So these are the innovations that are very difficult to measure. And these are innovations that we can broadly summarize as market-driven. And market, I don't talk about market, how much do you sell, it's the broad market surrounding companies. So if you look at the first type of innovation in ICT, biotech, nanotechnologies, this is an indicator that we called, as economists, revealed competitive advantage or revealed technological